Now I am going to solve this problem 210. In this problem it is said that find the resultant of these two forces and find the angle of that resultant, which will be measured from the counterclockwise direction from the positive x-axis. So we are given these two forces and their angles with the y and x-axis respectively, right? So to find the resultant we will use the parallelogram law. To apply parallelogram law, I will draw this 500 pound force on the head of that 800 pound force and I will complete the parallelogram. Let's suppose if this is that 500 pound force, right, this red one, this is 500 pound force and it is parallel to that 500 pound force, right? So this will be the resultant of these two forces. If I join the tail of this first one, this 800 pound force, to the head of this 500 pound force, and if I draw this same 800 newton force on the head of this 500 pound force, so we will get that parallelogram, right? So let's suppose if I draw that 800 pound force on the head of this 500 pound force, so this will be the parallelogram, right? So we are asked to find the magnitude of this resultant and this angle which it is making with the positive x-axis, and this angle should be measured in the counterclockwise direction. So let's suppose this is the theta. Now if I extend the line of action of this force, right, this 800 pound force, so this angle is known, right, from here. So let's suppose that this angle is alpha, right? So as we can see that this angle alpha is between this 800 pound force and this 500 pound force. So this means that this is that angle, right? This is that alpha angle. So let me write that this purple one is alpha angle, right? And what is the magnitude of this alpha angle? So if this is 40 degrees and this is x-axis and this is y-axis, so this complete angle is 90 degrees. This complete angle is 90 degrees. Right, so if this is 40, so then this means that this angle is 50 degrees. So let me write that this is 50. And if this is 50 and this is 35, so then alpha is equal to 50 plus 35, which is 85 degrees, right? So this means that if the angle between 800 pound force and 500 pound force is 85 degrees, so then this angle is also the same. This is that 85 degrees angle, right? So if this is 85 degrees, so then this angle and this angle alpha are supplementary angles. So we can find this by subtracting this angle from 180 degrees, right? So 180 minus 85, so then this angle is 95 degrees, right? So now we know the included angle between these two forces, right? So this is 800 pound and this is 500 pound force, and we are asked to find the magnitude of this resultant, right? So we can apply cosine's law. So R will be equal to 800 squared plus 500 squared minus 2, 800 multiplied by 500 cos of the included angle, which is 95 degrees, and we will take square root to get the magnitude of the resultant. So this will give us the resultant magnitude. So this is equal to approximately 980 pounds, right? So this is the magnitude resultant, which is equal to 980 pounds. To find this theta, we need to find this angle, right? Let's suppose gamma, right? So if we find this gamma angle, so then this theta will be equal to 50 minus this gamma, right? So 50 minus gamma. So we can apply sine's law now, since we know the magnitude of this resultant, which is 980 pounds, right? So if I apply sine's law, so then sine of gamma divided by the magnitude of the opposite force, this is 500, this will be equal to sine of 95 degrees divided by the resultant magnitude, that is 980, right? So gamma will be equal to sine inverse 500 into sine of 95 degrees divided by 980. So gamma comes out to be 30.56 degrees, right? So then this is that gamma. So to find that theta, theta is equal to 50 minus gamma, and theta is that angle of the resultant which is measured from the positive x-axis in the counterclockwise direction, right? So this is that theta, and theta is equal to 50 minus gamma, which is 30.56. So when I solve this, so we will get the theta, right? So this comes out to be 19.45 degrees. So this is the solution of this problem.